Hi all, my name is Mr. Anderson, and as you can see, we're at Mr. Anderson's Tobacco Emporium. It's my tobacco shop. Today I'm going to be talking to you about my former employee, Mary Rogers, and her tragic tale. Mary used to work the counter at my store. She was a great employee. She generated the most wealth of anyone I've ever had. She was beautiful and loved by all, as well as desired by many. But one day, Mary didn't show up for work. She didn't come. She was missing for 3 days, and I was very worried. This is her tragic story. Good day. My name's Mr. Payne. I'm a former friend of Mary. I loved her very much. She was also a great worker, very organized, very courteous, very kind, and of course, very beautiful. I have to admit I had a big crush on her, as many gentlemen did. However, I was a little more successful. I got her number, yeah. However, after I got her number, she disappeared. I called her, but she wouldn't respond. She was missing. I, as well as everyone else, went to look for her throughout the city. Her body was discovered floating off the shores of Weehawken, New Jersey in the Hudson River. She was brought ashore and pronounced dead immediately. The coroner noticed many bruises on her body, as well as hand marks around her neck. Her handkerchief was tied in a sailor's knot.
There are many theories about my murder. Murder mystery number one. Some people think I was murdered by a gang of ruffians. They are a gang indigenous to New York in this time period. Also, murder number two. Some people were writing in the newspapers that I was murdered by a Navy lieutenant. Hence, my sailor's knot on my dead body, okay? And number three. Some people think I went for an abortion, an atrocious abortion that resulted in complications, and they wanted to hide the evidence, so I went for a swim, if you catch my drift. And number four, some people think this dead body isn't me, and I'm in Europe or another state. I will now rest my case.
Greetings, I am Edgar Allan Poe. It is my job to put those who are guilty for the Mary Rogers murder to justice. As of now, the murder is still unsolved. However, there have been many literary works about the subject. Today I'll be talking to you about two of those. The first being The Beautiful Cigar Girl by Daniel Stashower. This is a non-fiction work, essentially a reference textbook about the 18th century New York murder. In addition, I'll be talking about the fictitious piece called On Night Shore by Randall Silvis. There are new characters and a new twist at the end of the novel. It's a very good book.
Okay, in 3, 2, 1, go. You're doing it.
Are you filming?
Mm-hmm.
Why?
Oh, it's okay. We gotta let some water in. This is another version of the account with different characters and one thing.
So I'm gonna knock that now. Oh, you're not filming anything else?
No! Hold on, how are you filming? Are you filming just going up and then?
But I'll do that after. But right now, okay. It's just still.
Now, can you just see my hands?
Yep.
Good.
Okay, in 3, 2, 1, go. Go.
What the f*** is that?
You have to have your number.
Perfect.
F*** sake! Can I buy you dinner? How much would that be?
Depends, the dinner or the scars.
Be more flirty. Use your hand. Oh, shit. Okay. Sorry.
Like, can you make sure that nobody's seen
my eye?
Yeah. Like that? Okay.
At Mary Rod.
Ah. So now I gotta shoot this. Yeah.
Here you go, sweetheart.
Thanks.
Have a good day.
Roll me a kiss.